Let's fucking go.
What's going on, movers and groovers? Welcome back to Emeroy TV. If it's your first time here, welcome. If it's your second, third, fourth, millionth time here, welcome back. I appreciate you. Hope you're enjoying all the content that I'm sharing. If it is your first time here and you don't know exactly who the heck I am, I'm not TikTok famous or Instagram famous. I've been dancing for over 20 years, choreographing, teaching, and directing for over 15. And I'm going to be honest, and if you're wondering, like, well, why aren't you doing something like big things, backup dancing, choreographing? I have no aspirations to be a choreographer for artists or backup dancer for artists. I just really wanted to use, you know, have experiences with my artistry. If you want to have the conversation, you know, we can DM me. We'll talk about that. But anyways, just to give you a little bit of context on that. Anyways, I co-founded a competitive company called Family Business back in 2004, toured with a professional hip hop theater company called Antics, worked with organizations such as Culture Shock, Mixed Elements, Moving On Up Productions, and I currently direct a hip hop entertainment company called Temper Tantrum. Make sure you check out the YouTube channel because they also do reaction videos as a group, as a company. Not as consistent as this, but you know, it's interesting having like multiple people of different experiences of dancing sharing their thoughts. So make sure you check that out as well. And if it's your first time here and you don't know exactly how, you know, why you're confused as to why these, you know, these reaction videos are so long, okay, it's a three-phase process. Phase one, I just react to the videos, you know, no interruptions. I just react to it and comment on it. Phase two is where I put my choreographer director hat on and I just, you know, share all my thoughts, that all the things that I'm loving, things I know that they worked on. You know, I essentially like call things out as they are because I don't know the intention, the vision, what they have in mind. I'm just seeing it as it is, asking questions, observing, and kind of like sharing with you guys the things that I'm noticing as a dancer, director, choreographer, all this other stuff from years of experience. And aiming to share my knowledge with you guys, especially those of you guys who are aspiring dancers. Okay, and phase three is watching the vision come to life, you know, a version of it through a performance on stage, you know, sometimes occasionally a performance video. But yeah, that's essentially like the three-phase process. And with that, let's head on to the video. Also, here's one. I love the product placement happening in the front. Oh, what the fuck just happened there? He just rose from the dead. Nice pickup. Oof. Nice strong shapes and then switching it up some intricate musicality. Very typical. Ooh. Nice ripple. Ooh, let's go, musicality. Love the strong shapes. Very defined movements. Love that he has the mic already. Okay, slide back. Great dynamics. If you want to make your choreography look more dynamic, change the direction. It's a little amp up there. Nice. Nice, a little dynamic with that. Simple, like, rise up to the body roll. Nice, I like that. little magic trick happening there. Okay. Oh my god. I always thought he was gonna hit his head on that fucking on the ceiling. This is a refreshing, different vibe. Very dramatic. Let's go. Great use of the levels. I love how everything is just building up. It's all chaotic, then it's gonna probably lead to the climax. Look at the amount of movement that's happening. I'm expecting something to like maybe slow down or maybe a pause, but I don't know. Yep, there's a slowdown right there. It just makes sense as they're building up. Okay. Frame. That symbolism means. I think I should read the lyrics before I watch these, but then that just, I feel like that would take more time. Dance, shit. Okay, first thing that I came up for me that as I was watching this is they're very strong, defined movements, and then switching it up. I think it's typical with a lot of the boy groups I watched is very strong, defined movements, and then switching it up into the much more gentle motions happening. And then love the moment where everything just felt chaotic, like boom, boom, boom. You felt like something was about to happen, and then they, boom, they silence it, like they chill, they reel it back in, which is a nice kind of like visual in terms of seeing the choreography because you're being thrown so much, but then everything just calms down. It's like the calm after the storm, so to speak. Pretty good use of the floor, considering the space looked kind of small, but it was nicely used. Nice, good use of the dynamics, sectioning off from different groups. Loved the friggin' dynamic in the beginning where the guy looked like he just fucking rose from the dead, and then the other one where he's essentially flying, but it looks like he's almost about to break the ceiling. So that I just imagine what would happen if you just lift him a little higher, or he just lifts his head up a little too high and just bah, bonk. And whatnot. Great execution, super clean, in my opinion. The choreography is there, up there. Like, complex, difficult. The fact that they're going onto the floor, going to a low level. I think musicality in the beginning, or actually through a lot of it, you can, in the analysis, I'll do my best to point out the different things that they're writing out through the beats. But yeah, that's it, off the top of my head. This has been on my list for the past few weeks, and I'm glad I finally got to watch it. Let's hop onto the analysis. Yo, hope you're enjoying the video so far. If you'd like to see more reaction videos and maybe even some dance videos, make sure to check out my dance company, Temper Tantrum's channel. We do K-pop reaction videos as well on some of your favorite artists, along with some other amazing content that I think you guys will enjoy as well. I'm probably going to forget to add the link in the YouTube card, so the link is in the description down below. See you guys there. Gonna guess, because I know YouTube, you're watching this way in the future, but I'm gonna guess that the other member is right here. Maybe. Sketch. Terrible sketch. Ooh, like a slit in his throat kind of thing. Intention with the fingers, always fun. I love the softness, so to speak, the gentleness, how it starts. I fucking love that part, man. This is a great dynamic right here. Simple, repetitive movements. The proper execution of it, because if you're like doing it, like I'm trying to get in frame for everything, there's just doing this, but then up, gives a different motion, or like a flow fast. Those are like how you execute the different textures. Like just, I'm just doing a simple movement, but how you execute the texture of it, it can add so much to the emotion of the song and the performance. Love this sectioning off of this, starting off with this middle diagonal group and then picking it up with the other group. Great pickup. Yeah, I love that. The doo-doo-doo-doo. Great musicality. Like, they're hitting like the basic boom, ga-ga, boom. Boom, ga, boom, ga-da, boom. See, you see that? Boom. Very sharp, man. Oh, bringing, very defined in their movements. Great dynamic, grid ripple. I feel like I've seen so much of, like, from all these videos, a lot of these circle ripples. And I like that there's different levels on this, going from this low level, mid level to standing level. Bring it back. Ooh, okay. Let's go with that musicality. Go, nice. Smooth transition into that. This is a 2-3-2. I'm guessing, but I'm not sure where the eighth member. 1-1-2-3-4-5-6-7. Yeah, I was told that there was an eighth member that's not here. Smooth transition into that. I'm guessing he's supposed to be his opposite, maybe. See, that's the thing too. Like, even if you have one of your members missing, if you can execute it well. Unless there's like a blatant huge hole or a dynamic that they're needed to be there, like, you know, that it's obvious that something's missing. If you can execute your choreography well without someone missing, people aren't going to notice. Great get down on that. So like they're using that groove, boom, grab, pull down. Boom. Dramatic. They have fucking limbs, dude. Just the shape of just like that pull. This shape right here. And then pulling it in. Oof. Thank you for the follow. Interesting. I like the use of the direction. It looks like, obviously, like they're facing a direction. It's him talking, some sort of interaction here. I'm guessing it's part of the story. So I don't know the lyrics. So I'm guessing they're having kind of like a confrontation. Boom, switch directions, boom. It's really clever. So boom, switch, now facing him. And it's a great use of like just, again, if you want to make your choreography feel more dynamic, just change the direction. It feels, because it's the way it's directing the eye. Oof. I'm loving that he's just adding a little extra, like anime, like villain bad boy vibes, as everyone's kind of chilling. He's adding a little, actually, he added a little extra too. Just like their head turning. I love this little fake out here. This is a nice angle for the camera as they do this big ass motion to this diagonal and they kind of give him a little magic trick here.
Wow, what is this movement? Going from his pyramid, spreading it out. How do they transition to that? What is this formation? Again, for people on YouTube, I know that there's a member missing. You guys are probably gonna see this like fucking 5 months from now. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is someone supposed to be here, right? Okay, I'm assuming. Maybe that might be where the missing person is. Might be wrong. We'll see when I watch the other one. I'm just interested in the... Damn, look at this formation change. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Interesting. Maybe he's supposed to be here. This is an interesting formation. Because they literally have everyone placed in a window so they can all be seen. See? So I'm guessing he might be here. But isn't the, I just... was amazing. I like this transition to this next formation. Alright, I could be wrong. That's where he might be, but it might be in the back. I don't know. Everything I hear, I'm guessing. See, this is where everything is starting to feel like super, like, crazy chaotic. Okay, that's center. I can see where it's off. It feels off center, but someone's missing, that's why. Like that. Like that part. Okay, knees. But, look at, like, the song is going faster, the movements is matching the energy. So you know it's like either it's gonna be like there's gonna be that quick pause moment. Boom. Damn vocals, let's go. Damn, they can sing, man. Damn, I'm really curious to see what the story is of this video. But we'll see if I have time to watch the music video. So, just to add to it, the dynamics were great. The musicality is, like I mentioned in the previous, they have some pretty good musicality. I think, honestly, through a lot of it, they really, that's one of the things I appreciate as a dancer, is like they pick on the beats, they ride the beats, and then they really sell the shit out of it. Great execution. Let's hop onto the performance and see what the performance looks like. Yeah, it is. Okay, I got the right version. This is a performance version, I think. Okay. Wardrobe is sick. Oh, forgot about that. Are those like rings on his hair? Yo, it's nice to actually hear the track. Because sometimes these choreography videos, like it's like raw audio. Which I don't mind too, because I get to hear the dance ASMR. Ooh, let's go. I don't know why, but look, he kind of makes me think... He reminded me of Todoroki. If you guys might watch My Hero. Nice cut. Damn, love the white. Damn, where did the wardrobe? Ah, nice, perfect. Love the cuts here. See, the thing with this song, it has a lot of strength to it, but it's also, I don't want to say chill, but like, it does have a kind of a dramatic kind of feel. Him, for some reason, he reminds you of Todoroki. And they match the choreography just perfectly. I kind of wish I was on the wide. Oh, yeah, that's fucking cool. Fantastic facial expressions or stage presence. But the choreography that matches it well, like, they're not trying to overdo too much. It matches the mood, and it fits well with what the artists are capable of doing. Damn, dude, he's like super freaking aggressive, but it's also like, but also looking fucking pretty, man. Let's fucking go. Yes, I wanted this shot. This set is fucking sick too. Shouts out to the set designer. Fantastic performance, facial expressions, energy. I think because it's a performance video, the artists do get a lot more opportunity to rest in between takes, and the editor gets to choose which one looks best. So energy was, I think, consistent, obviously, but I think the choreography felt a lot more crisper in a lot of the takes. Wardrobe, fantastic. I'm gonna say this a million times, I'm not the guy for wardrobe. I like the fact that it's like either you get like a strong black, like, or dark colors, and then all of a sudden the whites, and then all of a sudden the reds. I'm like, oh hey, my favorite colors. But yeah, like, same with this, the whites. I think I've said this before, like, the thing with like the whites, it can be risky. I guess it depends on the floor you're gonna be performing on, because it can easily expose like the lack of cleanliness. I'm not saying they aren't clean, for other people. So those are things to consider if you're putting together a competition routine and whatnot. But these guys, it looked fucking great. I think between the white and the black, I think, actually no, I'm going with the red, because red's my favorite color. Not even a discussion anymore.
All right, so that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you guys like it, make sure you hit like, subscribe, share this with friends who you think might enjoy it. And make sure you turn on the bell button so you guys are getting notifications, especially when I go live. Because when I do create new content, do create new reactions, I do it live now. And it's a fun experience, so we can kind of like have a talk back and forth. I learn a little bit more about you guys, a little bit more of the artists that you enjoy. It's a fun little, you know, two-sided conversation instead of just me talking to a camera. So hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.